Hello friends, welcome to my channel Fun Paper Scissors. In today's video, I'll be creating this number plate for my house. To begin with, I'm using an MDF sheet and I'll be using Fevicryl molded clay and clay modeling tools which are available online. I've already placed the hook at the back of my MDF sheet and written the number of a house and the name in pencil already. To begin with, I will take equal amount of base and hardener of the clay, mix them evenly. The best part of this clay is once it dries out, the surface is very smooth, there are no cracks, and that's why I really like using this clay. Once you've done that, sprinkle talcum powder on the board and roll out your clay evenly with the help of a pencil which has a circular cross section. Next, with the help of my tools, I am cutting out flowers. This is a large flower. I'll place it at the left corner. For that I'm using fabric glue. In order to make this more beautiful, I will be cutting out another flower which is slightly smaller in size, and I'll be pasting that on top of this flower so that it looks more beautiful. And finally, to complete it, I'm pasting another very tiny flower of the same design on the center of it so that finally it looks very beautiful. Next, I'm creating a 5-petal flower by the side. Again, this also has two layers. And with the help of the modeling tools, I am making it more delicate. You can keep playing around with these different flower cutting stencils which come with this set. There are close to 50 pieces if I am not wrong. So you can create as many patterns of flowers and leaves as you may like. You may fill in even more flowers than what I have. And the entire process is super fun. So if you are looking for ways to spend time on weekends and have fun with kids, this is the best way to, you know, engage everyone. So I am pasting flowers with 5 petals, 6 petals and more, and also leaves, so that my creation finally looks quite complete. I am placing the tinier flowers at the outside of the design and also between larger flowers, and I'm placing the leaves beneath the flowers so that it gives a 3D effect to it. Yeah, so more or less this is my final design. Now I'll be creating a border on the sides of the board so that my complete design, once I paint it, it looks more delicate, because there's floral pattern only in one corner, so it shouldn't look plain elsewhere. Again, pasting this border with fabric glue as I've done before. Once I'll color this border, it would stand out, you know, very delicate and beautiful. I'll place the border at all the edges of this square board. Yeah, I'm almost done with the border. Now I'll be using the same clay further and paste it onto the numbers of my house, letters and numbers. So again, in the same way, I'll keep pasting it. So while I was creating this, I did not cut the clay beforehand to size and then paste it. I just thought doing it this way, you know, cutting it after pasting it onto the numbers and letters would be faster. But you could also try to, you know, first cut it to size and then paste it with the glue. That's completely your choice. So this is a relatively straightforward process of pasting the numbers, and but be careful when you've already written out the numbers in pencil beneath. So I've used rulers and you know margins to ensure that it's in the right place and in the right size, because that's the main focus area of this design. So you can't get wrong over there. Yeah, I've done the numbers. Now comes the name of our house, and in order to do that, I'm not using clay over here because those are really tiny letters. So I'm going to write it using a 3D outliner by Fevicryl. This one is golden in color. The color is not really important over here because this would be covered in acrylic colors again. So that's completely fine. Yeah, after everything dries out, this is how it looks. I'm using acrylic colors by Fevicryl, and I'm painting the background using a mixture of white and yellow because I want the background to be really light, and I'm also evening out the brush marks using roller brush. So this was completely fun for me to finish the background. This is how it looks. After that, I am painting the leaves using sap green color. So you could also paint the leaves in different shades of green. This is the first flower which I had created. I am painting it yellow. And for the next 15-20 minutes, I just kept playing around with different shades which I already had, and you know, painting the flowers and then painting them again in different colors. That's how it looks. And now I am painting the border with a dark green color, which is in, you know, stark contrast with my light yellow background. This is how it looks. Now I'll paint the letters and numbers of my house. This is also a shade of green, but it's slightly lighter than the background. And finally, I'm painting the name of my house, which I've written out in the 3D outliner. This is in light blue color, and this combination of light blue and green really looks pretty on my light yellow background. And this is how my number plate for my house finally looks. Do let me know in the comment section below how you find it, and please do subscribe to my channel for more such fun videos. Thank you for watching.